Okay. Strength of the relationship. How strong is the relationship? Look at the scalar plot. Okay, in this picture, you see two scalar plots, one nested inside the other. And the question is, which one shows a stronger linear association? Both scalar plots are football shape. So, of course, it's the one nested inside, right? Because it's more close to what? To the fitted line, okay? Which one shows a stronger linear association? You say the one nested inside. Okay, now second one, you find one. Also two scalar plot, one also nested inside the other one. Now, this one is a curve, okay? Which one shows a stronger non-linear relationship? Same thing. The one nested what? Inside. Now, believe me, if people give you a data set, x1, y1, x2, y2, up to xn, yn, can you simply look at the data and say this is strong or weak? Believe me, nobody is that good. You have to plot the data, okay? That's why when people give us the data set, to describe the data set, you always begin with a graph, okay? You cannot just look at the number and say how strong is the association, okay? Now, next one, cluster, outliers, and trends, okay? Look at the first picture here. This is a very interesting picture. This is called two cluster, okay? This is cluster one. And this one is cluster two. Cluster one, football shape. And you find there is a positive association. And cluster two, you fit it by a line because it's also football shape. You find there's a negative association. But if you put cluster one, cluster two together, you look at overall tendency. What do you find? You find overall there's a positive association. If you use computer software package to compute it, you will also find it's positive. But can you say there's a positive association between X and Y? The answer is no, you cannot do that, okay? When you see two clusters, what you should do? You should investigate them individually. You should say there are two clusters. Cluster one shows a positive association, and this is what? The second cluster shows a negative association, okay? When you see clusters, you should investigate them individually, okay? And this picture, if I call, this is the overall pattern. Then this one is outside the overall pattern. We call what? Outlier, okay? And remember, when we see outlier, what should we do? We should find out the reason why they appear. Don't just believe them, okay? Okay, let's look at the next topic. Categorical variables in scatter plot. To add a categorical variable to a scatter plot, we can use a different plot color or symbol for each categories, okay? Let me give you a concrete example. Do taller people make more money? I want you guys to think about it, okay? A social psychologist can stumble on a strong positive association between height and salary if he failed to bring into what? The analysis of another what? Relevant factor, okay? Now, this is actually a very famous study. done by a sociologist before. But this guy made a mistake. Let's see what kind of mistake he made. X is what? It's height. And what's Y? Y is a salary. Okay? And the sociologist find many pairs of what? Find many peoples, and recall their height and their salary. What did he find? He find there is a very strong one, positive association. Okay? So, the the taller make what? More money. You know what? This is wrong. Why this is wrong? To answer the question, okay, let me give you a hint. I ask you guys to think about the question, okay? In your family or in your house, if your father is shorter than your mom, raise your hand. Come on, guys. If you don't know how to raise your hand, you can just what? Turn on the screen so I can see your face. I call this is class participation. If in your family, your mom is taller than your dad, raise your hand. See, no one, right? A second question. If in your family, your mom make more money than your dad, raise your hand. Again, no one. That explains the story, okay? Now, this picture actually consists of what? Two graphs. I use two different colors. This is male, and the other group is what? Female. Okay? Two big round ball. In human society, male are taller than female. And in human society, male got paid more than what? Female. Not because female is less capable of making money, because female have different what? Social responsibility. They need to what? Take care of their family, take care of babies. Okay? Even they really want to work, they work for part-time. So this is a story, okay? There is a added categorical variable. And that is what? Gender, okay? When you deal with the added categorical variable, you use different color of this different symbol. Male, you can use a check. Female, you can use what? A triangle. Okay, different symbol to represent data from different what? Categories, okay? If you look at the picture separately, you find they are both what? Like a big round ball. Look at the picture here. Taller woman equally related to what? Rich and poor. Shorter woman equally related to what? rich or poor, right? So when you tell me tall or short, I don't know which one is more related to, okay? So actually look at what? Each gender. No association between what? No association between high and what? Salary, okay? So you should say the taller are more related to what? Higher income. Why taller are more related to high income? Because the taller are most likely what? Male. And male get paid more than what? Female. This is the reason why, okay? Look at here. When you make the scatter plot, you find big round ball means what? No association. No association among females, no association among what? Males. But when you put male and female together, you find there is a positive association, okay? So you shouldn't say the total make more money. You should say the total are more related to high income. Since the total are most likely male. Okay? Let's move to the next page. Okay, I give you four different pictures here. You can find the red one, red dots, and the triangles are in blue ink. Okay, so you can see there are two groups of what? Data. The red ones, the red dots, positive association. Look at the triangles. They are also positive association, okay? Positive, this is positive. So together, what do you find? When you put the two groups together, overall, still positive. Okay? The overall direction is consistent with what? With subgroups. When overall direction is consistent with subgroups direction, group one, group two, both positive association, we call this is what? Genuine relationship, okay? Now look at the second picture. Again, the red dot. And the triangle is what? Blue. Okay? The red one is a big round ball, no association. But how about the triangle ones? Positive association. Okay? Now, so what is the relationship between X and Y? In this case, we call conditional relationship. If you conditional on the red group, no association. But if you conditional on the blue group, you see a positive association. So what is the relationship between X and Y? You cannot look at the whole thing. You should use what? Well, conditional on the red group, no association. But conditional on what? The blue ones, huh? Positive association. Now, look at the third picture. The red dots, big round ball, no association. The triangles, also what? A big round ball, no association. But two group, they have no association. But when you put them together, what do you find? You find there is a positive association. In statistic term, we call this is spurious. Okay? If you check your dictionary, spurious means what? Means fake. If you look at individual groups, no association. But when you put them together, you find a positive association. That positive association is fake, okay? Just like this one here. If you look at male group, no relationship between height and salary. If you look at female group, no association between height and salary. But when you put these two groups together, you find there is a positive association. That positive association is a fake. We call this is what? Spurious. Okay? So what's the answer? Can you say total people make more money? No. What you should say? You should say total are more related to higher income because total are most likely what? Male. Okay? If you look at male and female group individually, actually there is no association between what? Income and height. Okay? So that relationship, it looked like a positive association between what? Income and height. That relationship is fake. We call spurious. Okay? The last one is even more amazing. Okay? Let's take a close look about the last one. If you look at the red dots, what do you find? You find there's a negative association. Okay? Very weak negative association. But if you look at the triangle ones, also a very weak negative association. However, when you put them together, what's the big picture? You find there is a very weak one, positive association. That is called changed relationship. Okay? Changed relationship. If you want a copy, go ahead.